Hi friends, in this video let us discuss Thevenin's theorem. The statement of Thevenin theorem is, in any linear bilateral network can be replaced by a voltage source VTH and the voltage source VTH and with the equivalent resistance RTH connected in series. That means the entire circuit, the bigger circuit, can be transformed into VTH and the resistance, Thevenin resistance RTH. Now our job is to find out how to find VTH. VTH can be found out by replacing the load resistor RL, where we need to find any effect, maybe current, voltage and power across any resistance, and that resistance will be RL. At that place, just remove the resistance RL and find the voltage across open circuit terminals, and that will be the VTH. And coming to RTH, in RTH there are two types. One is, if the sources are, all the sources are independent in nature, then remove RL and also remove all active sources by their internal resistances or impedances. We need to replace them. That means we need to replace the voltage source with a short circuit and a current source with a open circuit, and find the equivalent resistance from load side towards source side, and that will give you the RTH. This is the procedure to find RTH if the sources are independent in nature. If suppose the sources are dependent in nature, then we need to remove RL and we need to remove all active independent sources, and then we need to find open circuit voltage at the terminals of RL, and we need to find short circuit current at the terminals of RL. Now therefore the RTH can be given as VOC divided by ISC. So this is the procedure for Thevenin's theorem. So 5 ohm and 5 ohm are in series, so the resultant equivalent will be 10 ohm, and this 10 ohm and that 10 ohm are in parallel, so the equivalent is 5 ohm, and this 5 and this 5 will be in series, so the equivalent is 10 ohm. So finally the current passing at this point would be 1 ampere, as it is voltage is 10 volt and the resistance is 10 ohm. So this is the thing, and here 10 ohm and here also it is 10 ohm, so the current passing here is 0.5 ampere. So finally the current passing is 0.5 ampere. So this is our circuit. So we know what is the current passing through resistor R4. Now let us try to obtain the same thing by using Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So let us find VTH. Now VTH, according to this, we need to remove RL. Yes, RL has been removed and the other circuit remains as it is. So this is plus and minus and like this. So R4 is removed. So the voltage is 10 volt as we know, and this is 5 ohm, and here also it is 5 ohm, and this is 10 ohm. R4 is removed completely and we need to find VOC here. As we know, there is no current passing in this line, so VOC would be plus and minus. So the current passing through 10 ohm into the 10. Therefore, VOC or VTH, VOC is equal to 10 into current I, where the current I is this one into 10 divided by 10 is the voltage divided by resistances. Equivalent resistances are 5 plus 10. And this 5 ohm resistor is not at all contributing anything to the network. So that will not be taken. And this is the thing. So this is finally 100 divided by 15. Let us keep like that only. Now let us, this is the VOC or VTH. And the next step would be how to find RTH. For RTH, the concept is simple. First, remove the RL, as RL has been removed. And next, remove active sources by their internal resistances. So for voltage source, it should be short circuited, and I have shorted it. And this is the thing. Now I need to find RTH here. Like this. This is 5 ohm, this is 10 ohm, and this is also 5 ohm. Now RTH, to find RTH, this 5 ohm and this 10 ohm are in parallel. So RTH would be 5 into 10 by 5 plus 10, and this combination is in series with this 5, so plus 5. This would be 50 divided by 15 plus 5, which is equal to 50. 15 into 5 is 75, so it should be 125 by 15. Now I need to find equivalent circuit of Thevenin equivalent circuit to find the current passing through R4, and the circuit would be like this. So here it is VTH or VOC is 100 by 15 and RTH is 125 by 15, and this would be 5. Need to find the current here. Current I is equal to 100 by 15 divided by some these two by 125 by 15 plus 5 is equal to, it is 100 by 15 divided by 200 by 15. 15, 15 will get cancelled, 0, 0, 0, 0, and finally it will be 0.5 ampere. So this is the thing for Thevenin theorem. So this first, let us recapture all the things regarding Thevenin's theorem. Thevenin's theorem, in a linear bilateral network, the entire circuit can be transformed into one voltage source in series with the resistance. The voltage source is called VTH and the resistance is called RTH. And how to find VTH? VTH can be found out by removing RL and finding out the voltage across the open terminals at RL. Okay. And this is, next step is how to find RTH. RTH can be found out. Actually, there are two cases in RTH. If the sources are independent in nature, simply remove RL and remove all active sources with their internal resistances. Voltage source has to be replaced as short circuit and current source has to be replaced with open circuit. If the sources are dependent sources, and here for independent sources, you need to find the equivalent resistance seen from the load towards the source, that is the case. And coming to dependent source, we need to remove RL and we need to remove all active independent sources, and we need to find VOC across the removed terminals of RL, and we need to find ISC across the removed terminals of RL. Then RTH would be VOC divided by ISC. So this is the concept of Thevenin's theorem. Now this is one of the examples and how this would be replaced as Thevenin's equivalent circuit. and this is very simple. Simply according to this, we have removed the R4 and we have found out VOC across these two terminals, and this is the value. And in the next step, as only independent sources are present, we need to follow this step. So the active source here is voltage source, so we need to short it out. And then we have again, yet to we have removed RL here, and we need to see RTH from this side and up to source, and this is the RTH. The value of RTH is like this. And finally, this is the Thevenin equivalent circuit, and here we need to find the current. Obviously this current should be equal to this current, hence the Thevenin's theorem is proved. Thank you very much.